I think after starting Muay Thai, mind, body, and spirit became this whole new thing to me, where it has a lot to do with perseverance and meditation, kind of when you're training and getting into this zone where you're just trying to better yourself. Whether it's like listening to stuff that your coach says, or just trying to run a little harder or punch a little harder each day, you're just like improving yourself. I think the longer I do Muay Thai, the more I feel that it is very kind of a spiritual thing, I guess. Pretty obsessed with it right now. And, you know, it's my passion. So I guess once you find something that you're that passionate about, you can apply it to, like, mind, body, and spirit. Hi, my name is Angela Hill, and I'm an American athlete. I like to watch people who I kind of admire, like, especially when it comes to fighters. Whenever I see someone who just trains their heart out and, you know, is on top, that gives me motivation myself. Like, I haven't been doing it for that long, but I still have managed, like, most of my opponents have been training years longer than me, like maybe even twice as long. And I feel like if I just keep driving forward, then I could be like on top. I can be a champion, I could be a world champ, you know? And I think just striving for that gives me the focus that I need to keep training hard and keep trying to improve myself, keep trying to beat up the guys, you know, keep trying to keep up with the younger guys, you know. So like, I think there's tons of challenges in this sport that always make it interesting, always make it exciting to come back to training the next day, and that's what keeps me going. I've been training Muay Thai for 3 years. It'll be 3 years in August. And just right off the bat, I was hooked. I started training with Brandon Levi. He's like this perverted, goofy looking Australian guy. He's like the coolest guy you'd ever meet. Like, just one of those people who are really charismatic, and he pulled me into the sport. So I'm really thankful that I ran into him first, because I think if I had started with any other gym or any other crew, I wouldn't have been as, I guess, attached to it as I am now.
She's a complete package. Skills, strength, speed, and aggression.
I've always been aggressive. Like, it's one of those things where the more you know, the more you can balance out that difference between size and strength. So if I know more than like a 200 pound guy, might have more of a chance, you know what I mean? So it was really fun for me, because I could be like super aggressive with it, but I'm this little thing, so people wouldn't know what to do.
She was very naturally athletic and very keen. She was a hard worker right off the bat. And you can always tell when people are willing to put in the work and they don't say too much, they just get into it, you know that they've got potential.
Like, at first it just kind of looked like brawling, but now I'm starting to refine it.
She's a come forward fighter, none too tricky, but she's got good basics and she uses them. She presses the attack all the time. I think she's a natural athlete.
And right now, aggression's working for me. I have the stamina to keep it going, so I might as well use it, you know? Mentally, when I prepare for a fight, a lot of times I stalk. I'll spend hours online stalking my opponent. But in this case, I wasn't able to find too much, but I don't know, I like to create this character in my head, and then I just imagine every possible thing that they could throw at me, or every possible like situation that could happen in the ring, and I try to prepare myself for that. Like, what happens if she backs me up? You know, what happens if like I get hit with a nasty shot and everything goes blurry? Like, I try to kind of focus on those things, and like a lot of times I'll think about that stuff like while I'm running, or while I'm hitting the bag, and just using that so I can like use that time to just kind of meditate on the upcoming fight.
Joel Becker scored this contest 29-28 for your winner by split decision. And still up the green.
Trying to survive. I believe that life is a prize, but to live doesn't mean you're alive. Don't worry about me and who I fire. I get what I desire, it's my empire. And yes, I call the shots, I am the umpire. I sprinkle holy water upon the vampire. In this very moment, I'm king. In this very moment, I slay Goliath with a sling. This very moment, I bring, put it on everything. That I will retire with the ring, and I will retire with the crown. Yes.